Hey everybody, ParryMish777 here. Sorry I've been away so long. I've been really sick and really busy and just haven't been around much. Looking at a very interesting article right now, and I'm going to put the link to it up here so that you can check it out for yourself, because there's quite a lot of comments on it, and I thought it would be interesting if you want to check out the comments and the conversation that's going on beneath the article. Because that's way more entertaining than the article itself, let me tell you. Joined in the fun there myself, and been going for 2 days now. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. Anyway, I heard about this update from a friend of mine. So I want to talk about this woman. Her name is Lina Joy in Malaysia. She's Malay. She was born a Muslim. And she decided that she was going to be a Christian. She changed her name. And she had her ID card changed to reflect that. But she has been in court for the last number of years. I believe it's since 1998. Because the stated religion on her card is Islam. Because of the fact that she's Malay. And that is the national religion of the country. And she wanted to have that changed along with the name to reflect her new choice in religion, her being a Christian. She's engaged to a Christian man, and without this card she cannot marry him. She cannot have or keep her kids. This card identifies who she is, the rights that she has, and everything like that. So, you know, as far as I'm concerned, it's very important for her to have this card and to have it accurate. So I understand why she went to court. Now, she's been in court for, 9 years now? And the verdict came back just yesterday. Sorry, it would have been the day before yesterday now. My time's kind of messed up because Malaysia's 14 hours ahead of me, and I got the news last night, just a few hours before now. So anyway, it was 2 days ago. So the verdict came back. She went through court to try to get her religion taken off the card, and they refused. Civil court said that it's not their jurisdiction because it has to do with Islam, even though she's not a Muslim. She was born a Muslim. She's considered a Muslim. She's under Sharia law. She has to go to Sharia court to have this addressed and to have it changed. Check out the link and check out the comments, because that pretty much covers everything I want to talk about. Wow, there's just too much there to say. I think it's ridiculous. I mean, if you take religion out of it, and, you know, and because of the conversation that's gone on, you know, people have come out and said, you know, why are you bashing Islam? Why are you bashing Muslims? Why are you saying this? Why are you saying that? You know, to various people that have left comments on there. I'm sure I'm included in there somewhere. But if you take religion out of the picture and just think about the government for a second, there's two forms of government. There's the civil law, or the civil court, and then there's the Sharia court, which is because of the Islamic religion in the state, that law is in place specifically for Muslim people. And I don't think it should be there. I mean, but let's say it is. Okay, so this woman, being born a Muslim, they want her to go to this Muslim court. Do you really think that they're going to allow her to denounce her religion and to have that changed? As far as I'm concerned, it's not even a religious issue. It's a human rights issue. According to their constitution, it says that they have freedom of religion. Now, when you say freedom of religion, you know, as far as I'm concerned, you know, my understanding is the same as is in the U.S. Constitution, in the fact that you have the freedom to choose who you want to worship, how you want to worship, when you want to worship, where you want to worship, without fear of retribution. Okay? So this is what they do. They say you're free to practice the religion, but our head religion is Islam, and you have to follow our rules. So are you really free? You're not. You're not free at all. You know? I think it's her basic human right to be able to have whatever religion she wants and to have it stated on her card, because that card is her life, and that card gives her, you know, the freedom to do different things. She can't marry the man that she wants to marry because she's a different religion than this man. She's at risk for her life because she wants to denounce this religion, which she's not allowed to leave, under penalty of death. I mean, it even says in the law here, I'm going to look this up on the comments because I know that this is one of my main issues here, is what they say about this. Looking for this comment because I think it says something very important. It's a basic freedom right that's in the Constitution, and having her go under Sharia law contradicts that. It takes away from the constitutional right that she has to worship however she wants, because the Islamic law overrides it. In terms of her changing her religion, it being a religious issue, punishment is death. In Islam, it's clearly stated that no one leaves Islam. Those who choose to must be persuaded to stay, and if failed, the punishment is death. Okay, so I'll tell you what happens. And I'll put another link to another video about this too, the apostate or whatever condition of the woman who decides to leave Islam and what happens to them. And they're put in these camps. As far as I'm concerned, you can call it a concentration camp or a brainwashing camp or whatever. They're called rehabilitation. They're detained and they're put in jail for rehabilitation, which means they're basically forced to reconvert to Islam under fear of death. And they're tortured mentally and physically, and there is proof of this. And yet they say it's a peaceful religion and that they have the freedom to choose. But if they choose the wrong way, they are severely punished and under penalty of death. So tell me where the freedom is, you know? I don't know, I just... I'm hoping this woman goes to the Sharia law. I'm hoping she goes through the Sharia court and makes her case there, because it seems to be one of the only ways that, the only way, as far as all the talk is going, for her to be able to get this Islam taken off of her cart. Now, there's people that say that, well, she's a Christian. It really doesn't matter what her card says, it matters what's in her heart, and that's true, but she needs that card to live in the country. So the only other option is people say, well then why didn't she just leave? Why didn't she just leave the country, pack up and go to another country where she's free to be whatever she wants to be, and she can practice whatever religion she wants and have no worries about it. But that defeats the purpose of her going to court in the first place. And it defeats the purpose of what she's trying to do in staying and fighting for the basic human rights of women and for the basic human rights of people who choose not to be Muslim in a mainly Muslim country. Now, this is a religion that rules by fear and intimidation and brainwashing. And there's proof of this. There's proof that these people are tortured and these people are punished by death for believing something different. And I don't think that should happen. I mean, I don't think anybody should be treated any different. I will put the link to the column over here. And I will put the link to the other YouTube video that shows the state of the apostate woman that is jailed and put in this rehabilitation center. And you can see for yourselves what happens with that. And I'd like to see some video responses and some comments and see what you all have to say about this. I think it's very interesting. Go check out the column and the comments underneath. And be entertained, because there's some good stuff in there. And I'll talk to y'all later. Thanks. Bye.